As you all know, I am a massive fan of doing free weighted exercises for building up your back. I strongly believe that this is the most optimal way to do so, and this mainly comes in the form of heavy pulls and heavy rows, such as rack pulls, barbell rows, dumbbell rows, T-bar rows, even weighted pull-ups. Basically, the time-tested classic exercise that people have been using for a very long time that we know work. This is what I believe in, and I think that progression should be fundamental to any program, right? And you have to focus on this, and you have to raise your strength standards and not just be some guy who goes in and lifts really, really light weights and tries to get the biggest back possible. I'm not in favor of that. That said, though, I just want to clarify my stance on machines just in case some people didn't understand this in my last video. So I don't think that machines and cables are useless for building up the back. As a matter of fact, I think they are tremendously beneficial when used the correct way. So here's the thing, right? The upper back can recover rather quickly, a lot faster than you might imagine. That's why many people who run Bulgarian programs will do a block pull or a row every single day. It's very doable, especially if you're drug free. The upper back and the lats, and the trap neck area recovers very quickly. What doesn't recover quickly is the lower back. And that's why things like conventional deadlifts every day might cause you to get injured, or doing a good morning every day, you see? So there is a clear difference between the upper back and the lower back. That said, when you do machine rows, you can focus on that upper back without the lower back's recovery being an issue. And that's why I like it, and that's why I recommend it. You see, let's say you did a very heavy workout the day before. Let's say you went on Monday, some rack pulls, some rows, some shrugs, and you left the gym, right? Well, if you're going again Tuesday and you attempt to repeat a heavy free-weighted row, you might get injured, or you might experience some lower back discomfort. So what's the best thing to do? Machine rows. Chest-supported, cable, even hammer strength, all these machines can benefit you if your lower back is starting to recover, because the upper back could handle that type of volume. In fact, I think it was Josh Bryant who said this, that you should be rowing like 5 times a week, right? Now, whether you agree with that or not is up for you to decide. I think that rows could be done at a higher frequency and your upper back does recover quickly. So I do understand that point. I think it's a great thing to say, you know, that your upper back can handle a lot of volume. It can handle a lot of stress, and doing things like machine rows will allow you to get that extra volume and act as a form of restoration, because that's the next benefit. It is restoration and it enhances your recovery. The more volume you put into that upper back, the bigger it's going to get, and the less injuries you're going to have, and the stronger you're going to get at free-weighted exercises. Because if your back's already going to recover quickly, why not hit it again? You could do it, right? I'll do this many times in my mini home workouts. I'll do like cable rows, you know, just for high repetitions. I'll use a lightweight, just pump it out. So I do believe in using this as a pumping strategy. On top of that, these cables and machines, they could be used within the training day itself if your lower back is like feeling eh. You know, or you don't feel like doing a free-weighted row. That's what I do. If I just did a heavy rack pull and I have zero desire to do a barbell shrug or a freaking Yates row or a barbell row or anything, I'm just going to do a machine. So it is the best thing to do when you are lazy. Honestly, it is. And then at the end of your workout, you could just hit more lower back work to compensate for the fact that you didn't really hit it optimally. But yeah, I'm not against machines or cables. If you read Naturally Enhanced, you will see that I included some of these movements because of their rejuvenation benefits. Rows should be your new religion. Make them so, because they are tremendously beneficial and you can't go wrong. And I know some powerlifters actually do a back workout before their bench training. That's how advantageous it is. I know that Brian Alistair believes in doing your rows before your presses, right? Like in a supersetting type of fashion or giant set type of fashion. So rows are fantastic, and it doesn't always have to be free-weighted. What I would say is this. As long as you're putting in the effort, there's a form of progression, and you're not being lazy. Basically, you're actively trying to get a bigger back, and it's not just you being a gym bro that focuses on chest and arms and, oh, I'm just going to do a cable row at the end of your workout. As long as you're not that guy, and you use these machines to your benefit, then you will experience the results. And then one final point I'd like to mention is that a lot of these machines and cables, it changes the strength curve such that it feels like bands. So peak contraction is maximized, which is pretty cool. So yeah, guys, I'm not against machine or cable rows. I'm against most pressing machines for the most part, and most machines in general in the gym. But in terms of the rows, the fact that you can add that volume and it acts as a form of rejuvenation, definitely incorporate. That's why you see me doing chest supported rows and lat pulldowns. I do that on a weekly basis for high reps, just to pump up the back, and it makes you feel so much better, right? So definitely include some of that stuff if you'd like to, or not, whatever your choice may be. Recognize that it is not worthless. And if it came off that way in my last video, that is absolutely not what I'm trying to say. I think you should get the best of all worlds by performing the heavy pulls being your foundation, and then that, the rows with the cables and all that as your supplementary work, or even as a main work if you're feeling lazy and the low back's causing some problems, you know? But yeah, don't disregard it just because it's a machine or a cable. A lot of these machines are very, very well done, all right? So that's it. Hope I clarified. Give me your feedback down below, and I will talk to you all next time.